With this new chapter, we ended up getting more information on Elantir, as well as Ferris not being the White Wizard at all. Again, that was a very interesting twist. But I was hoping for a Selene chapter, but it made sense on why Mystagun didn't have more information on Selene. Like, they got the basic information on Selene. Hey, this is a dragon that crosses dimensions. If you target Elantir, there's a chance that, you know, this dragon will become hostile with you, essentially. I mean, the easiest way to describe it. I'm like, yeah, she might get pissed off and show up. And they're just like, nope, anything beyond this information we don't need. We just need to know that we're not going to mess with her, and we need to make sure that there's no decision at any point to ever piss her off. And so, like I said, it makes sense on why Mystagun wouldn't know more about Selene. Like, if you only had the base amount. I mean, it's like with Actilogia, you only had to understand the very basic amount of, like, his story. This, that, like, a one sentence of him to be like, yeah, I'm not going to do anything to kind of, like, get that character to come my way. You're not going to want that. But with Ferris, Ferris is the one that holds a very interesting position, because she actually should know a lot about Selene. She should know, like, you know, just basic aspects of, oh, what is Selene like in Elantir? What is Selene's, you know, is there anything about her overall goal? Are you going to find a little bit about her abilities? I really want to see what it was like when Selene first showed up into Elantir. I really like this idea that Selene has to travel through the moon in order to cross dimensions. Like, I really love the idea of, like, just seeing this big snake-like dragon just kind of come out of the moon and fly its way down to the planet just to do whatever its schemes and goals are. Like, there's definitely a lot of visual just potential there, but Selene's just entrance is what I really want to see. I want to see what exactly was it like when she first arrived to this entirely other, like, completely different realm that she now apparently has control over and is a threat to entirely. Like, she apparently is a threat to this entire realm. I wonder what exactly that's going to amount to and where, like, her character art goes. Because, like, with Mersphobia and Alderaan, they didn't have huge character ties. Like, they didn't tie back into, like, a lot of things, like, immensely. Like, you only got, you know, with Mersphobia, you know, he was kind of reformed, like, he wanted to become a better person. And Alderaan, the only thing we really got about Alderaan was that at some point he tried to fight Acnologia 100 years after Acnologia, you know, started his genocidal campaign. And I'm still really hoping that, regardless if Alderaan is actually dead or what, I am hoping that he, you know, gives us the flashback, even if it's like 3 or 4 pages. I want to see him just try and fight Acnologia and see how that went. I mean, obviously we know how it went, but just, like, see some of the actions that took place. But with Selene, I feel like Selene's gonna have a lot of connections to, like, the large scale story, as well as other things in the past, like stuff with Galuna Island, the Belianese. There's magic she can connect to, like Fairy Glitter, maybe the Celestial Spirit Keys. There's a lot that she can really just end up being connected to throughout the story, and I think that holds a lot of potential for her, just her character in general. Like, we don't need some long explanation if it's like, oh, she's related to moon, you know, she's the reason why they invented Moondrip, she's where they came up with the idea or something. It's like, oh, cool, this general you know, parts of the story that now originate back to her, I think would be really fun. So I mean my big things for this next chapter are gonna be just Selene information. Like, I wanted that this chapter was 67, but like I said, it made sense on why they wouldn't have it. But now they're going to be communicating with Ferris, and she should absolutely, like I said, have a lot of just information to give us about her character. And I am extremely excited. Like, there's the general hype I have every time when a chapter comes around. It's like, sweet, new chapter. But the ones that I'm always the most excited for, like, big fight scene moments, obviously, and big information chapters, like finding out something big towards, like, you know, just giving us information on a current topic. Like, we still don't really know a lot about fifth generation dragon slayers. I remember how excited I was when Nibaru decided to just kind of drop near the end of a chapter, oh, I'm going to use fifth generation Dragon Force. And I was super excited because that's one of the things that I'd been waiting to see when it came to their abilities. And I was actually really happy because I was right about that prediction of how fifth generation Dragon Force worked. But I was just more happy to see the explanation rather than anything else. And I actually can't wait just to get information on Celine. Like, I really want to see what exactly she's like. Like, how do the people in Elantir see her? Like, how is her plan coming along now? Because she obviously has her schemes, but who knows, like, where they're at in, like, the, you know, the step-by-step plan of whatever she's got going up. Are we halfway through with whatever she's trying to accomplish? Are we 70% of the way? Either way, other than that, they'll comment below, thumbs up the video, but from the like button, subscribe button, and check out my other videos. But other than that, I appreciate everybody's already subscribed. Thank you all for listening. Bye.